I have been asked by many persons, why are we having this dialogue, this topic, these speakers only? I hereby clarify. Mr. Dhanraj Salecha, president of Rushabh Foundation, once visited the Islamic Research Foundation office about 1.5 months ago. He presented the Islamic Research Foundation kindly with a set of literature favoring vegetarianism. These included quotations from major world religions, which included quotations also from the Quran and sayings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, which according to him indicate that non-vegetarian food is prohibited for human beings. After some discussions, Mr. Salecha proposed that a public dialogue be held at Patkar Hall between Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri, president of the Indian Vegetarian Congress, and Dr. Zakir Naik, president of Islamic Research Foundation, on the topic, is non-vegetarian food permitted or prohibited for a human being? This would in turn enable the audience at large to know the different viewpoints of both the speakers and form their own judgment. Both the speakers agreed to the same. Just about 5 days back, that is this Tuesday, I met Mr. Zaveri, and he requested that both the speakers in their talk refrain from speaking on other religions except their own. Dr. Zakir, though being very ardently in the field of comparative religion, reluctantly agreed. Therefore, as far as the religious points are concerned in the talk and response of our speakers, Mr. Zaveri will speak only from the Jain viewpoint unless compelled otherwise. Similarly, Dr. Zakir will speak only from the Islamic viewpoint unless compelled otherwise. This, in brief, is the clarifying background to the dialogue. The format for the dialogue will be as agreed to and decided fair by the speakers. Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri will first address us for 50 minutes on the topic, is non-vegetarian food permitted or prohibited for a human being? Then Dr. Zakir Naik will make his presentation for 50 minutes on the same topic. This would be followed by a response session in which Mr. Zaveri will respond for 15 minutes to the matter presented by Dr. Zakir. Similarly, Dr. Zakir too would then respond for 15 minutes to the matter presented by Mr. Zaveri. When 5 minutes are left for the conclusion of the talk or the response time, I would put before each speaker a plate saying 5 minutes left, in which time they are expected to conclude. Lastly, we would have the question and answer session in which the audience may pose questions to each of the speakers alternately on the question mics provided in the auditorium. Written questions on slips of paper would be given secondary preference if time allows us. Now, I would request our first speaker, Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri, to present his address. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri.
Before I start my talk, I am really very happy that this atmosphere of brotherhood, it has really moved me. And I will request Dr. Zakir Naik to come forward and let's have a gale lag ja scene. The chief guest of this morning, Mr. Y.P. Trivedi, President of Rushabh Corporation, Sri Dhanraj Salecha, the learned speaker, Dr. Zakir Naik, the expert commentator and the coordinator, Dr. Mohammad Naik, Vice President of IBC, Sri Chaman Bhai Vora, other dignitaries on and off the dais, my friends, brothers and sisters. First of all, I must acknowledge the dedication, the sincerity with which all the three organizations, particularly Islam Research Foundation, has taken pains in arranging this lecture. I don't mind and I don't hesitate in saying the entire credit goes to IRF. Friends, the topic today is non-veg food permitted or prohibited for a human being? Any argument or any statement for that matter is always to be considered from a relative point of view. There cannot be any absolute truth, there cannot be any absolute statement that it is 100% prohibited or 100% permitted. So friends, let's see, as very rightly put in by Mr. Trivedi, who started the ball rolling, that we will not speak only from religious point of view. Religious has to enter. You can't divorce it from today's subject. But I would like to speak on this topic, that non-veg food is prohibited for human being from various angles. For example, geographical reason, historical reason, moral, ethical and religious reason, economical, environmental and ecological reasons, natural reasons and psychological reasons, and above all, medical reasons. It's a fact now well established that our actions are controlled by our thoughts. What we think, we act. And our thoughts are controlled by our diet. As we eat, so we behave. And that's why the topic is very important, that we should choose our diet in such a way that our thinking is positive. The word positive will include everything. And believe me, friends, not only all the religions, but the medical science has now proved that the food that we take, it definitely influences our thinking and so our behavior. Friends, there was a time when there was no alternative available, as Mr. Trivedi rightly put. There were places on this world, and there are even now places where there is no availability of vegetation. It is simply not possible because of the extreme circumstances.